On September 19th, 1783, the first passengers of their flying ball were a mutton, a duck, and a rooster. The stunned animals reached solid ground under their feet again, safe and sound. After France's King Louis XVI permitted human aviation, on October 15th, 1783, physicist Jean-François Pilâtre de Rozier became the first person to take to the air in a montgolfière. He reached the height of 26 meters. However, the balloon was still firmly anchored to the ground with ropes for safety reasons. The inventors were not on board. Their father had forbidden them to do so. But on November 21st of the same year, Rozier and Officer François d'Arlande took off from La Meute Castle near Paris without ropes. The two landed successfully and unharmed after 25 minutes on the Butte aux Cailles in Paris. Among the spectators was a certain Benjamin Franklin. He wrote, "A few months before, the idea of witches riding through the air on a broomstick and scientists on a bag of smoke would have seemed equally impossible and ridiculous." De Rozier experimented with the method of physicist Jacques-Alexandre César Charles, who had by then made a balloon fly with hydrogen. His experiment with explosive gas and open fire made him the first fatality in the history of aviation. While the Montgolfiers, by now endowed with titles of nobility, returned to paper production, balloon fever broke out in Europe and North America. Even balloon-shaped skirts and hats appeared in contemporary fashion. The Montgolfier brothers were the first to elevate people into the air. With their invention of the hot air balloon, they ushered in the age of aviation. And even today, balloons are used scientifically in the atmosphere. Well, so much for the Montgolfier brothers, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.